Good morning, Standard 9. Today we started the new chapter, Chapter 11, the Modern Age in Europe, Renaissance. Okay, at that time we had the three movements, the Renaissance, the Reformation, and then we had the Industrial Revolution. With this Renaissance, the Modern Age started, somewhere in the middle of 14th century, which continued till 17th century. Okay, so the Renaissance. Now, we come to the meaning of Renaissance. What is the meaning of Renaissance? Renaissance means rebirth or revival. Renaissance means the rebirth or revival. But you cannot end up. We are talking about what type of rebirth, what type of revival. Rebirth and revival of the ancient Greek and the Roman classics. Ancient Greek and the Roman classics. The study of, it is the revival of the study of the ancient and the Greek Roman classics. That is Renaissance. Okay, so I hope you understood here. Renaissance means rebirth or the revival of the study of Roman and the Greek classics. The next, as per your syllabus, we have now only two causes. Of the Renaissance. It does not mean that only these two causes are responsible. We have several causes which are responsible for Renaissance, but as per your syllabus, ICC, the new syllabus, you are going to study new trade route and invention of the printing press. Only two causes you are going to study here, new trade route. We'll start with new trade route. At that time, the Spain and Portugal navigators, they like to have the geographical exploration. The Spain and Portugal navigators like to have the geographical exploration, discovering new trade route. This was one of the reasons. Okay, they like to have the geographical exploration. The next, Constantinople fell into the hands of the Turks in 1453 AD. Constantinople fell into the hands of 1453 AD and the trade route between East and West closed. So as a result, they wanted to discover the new route to have a trade with the Eastern country. So like this, you can see that we had Prince Henry discovered Africa. Then Columbus discovered America. Vasco da Gama discovered India. Like this, we had some people discovering the new land. When these people came in contact with these new countries, the new places, they started interacting, which opened their mental horizon. So this was one of the cause for Renaissance. The second you have, the second cause, which is invention of the printing press. Now before the invention of the printing press, the books were handwritten. So it was not plenty. Now the first printing press was set up in Germany by Gutenberg, then Caxton set up in England. So like this printing press was set up and the printing press published plenty of books. So when they published plenty of books, plenty of Bibles also were published. The classic books were published, which opened, which made the people think. It opened the mental horizon of the people. People started thinking freely, which led to Renaissance. So here mainly you have to remember new trade route, the Spanish people and the Portugal people, the navigators. The Spanish and the Portugal navigators, they like to have the geographical exploration. So they went in search of new trade route because Constantinople was captured by Turks and it blocked the trade route between the East and the West. So they wanted to novel published in 20. So people came to know about them. Knowledge reached to more people and it opened the mental horizon of the people. So today, sir, we completed the meaning and only two courses which is there in your syllabus, new trade route and invention of printing press. Thank you.